Grant Marshall, head of women's services, together, for all of them. Let's hear from them. They're doing a great job. We have a lot of things in the hopper. One of them is our new incubator program, where we're looking towards some of our distressed communities, diverse communities, and picking out some of these abandoned lots and saying, you know what? County owns this for failure to pay taxes, for instance. Instead of auctioning it off to some speculator, why not give that property to a not-for-profit for $1? And then allow that not-for-profit to gain low-cost financing that we can arrange and construct an office incubator. And they, in turn, can provide low-cost rentals for upstart businesses that were formerly in someone's garage or attic or basement. And they can start to flourish. And they can share their conference rooms and their secretarial pool and their office equipment. And before you know it, there's a lot of these businesses starting to thrive in the area, and there's this filtering down effect, and success is contagious. We know that it presents a feeling of optimism within that community. So we're really high on this. We have one up and going right now in conjunction with a not-for-profit in North Babylon, and we're working on another in Huntington Station, and we're talking about one in Riverhead, and we've been talking to Teresa Sanders to work with one here, and I know she's working with the town of Islip and Central Islip. So the possibilities are endless when we work together with this type of a partnership. The other thing we're doing is we're creating our new website within Suffolk County, so businesses, particularly those businesses trying to get ahead, our women-owned businesses, our minority-owned businesses, will be able to register with our website. And then when we are going to solicit bids, we'll email them to let them know there's a bid coming up. Level the playing field. We have a disparity study, a legislation right now that's being voted on today, in fact, in committee, and hopefully it'll get out, that will take a look at whether or not our county is being fair with how the contracts are being let. So we're leveling the playing field. So economic development is a very, very important component of where we want to go. Then I know we have worked so much with our not-for-profits and our church leaders and our, our synagogue leaders, our religious leaders in general, when it comes to housing. And because I know sometimes the first place that those in need go when they're out on their own and they don't have housing is not necessarily the social services. It's knocking on the door of the local religious institution. And we've got to have that channeling of information so that we can work together to make sure people have a decent roof over their head and, more importantly, have hope to stay self-sufficient into the future. So when people talk about affordable housing, it's obviously very, very important because you all see the Long Island Index numbers where, you know, 70% of our young people, 18 to 30 years old, are thinking about leaving this island. And then you have 50% of all the population, because of the high taxes, they're thinking about leaving the island. Affordable housing is definitely very important. And we've got thousands of units that are now slated for development, but that's purchase. That's for a purchase. What about those people who can't even afford that for the purchase? What about the rentals that we need? That's an important component too. And that's where we have to work with our not-for-profit friends. The number of shelters that we have been able to develop over the last several years with our friends from the not-for-profit and faith-based community, you know what that's done for us? It allowed us to take the 200 families that we had housed up in motels, which is inhumane and so expensive, $5,000 a month to put a family there. It's down to 6. It was 200 families. But we work with our not-for-profits, found shelters in decent areas, put them in there, and they can raise their family in a much more decent surrounding.
It is our prayer that scenes from our inaugural celebration and dedication has encouraged you and inspired you that dreams and visions can become a reality. As you begin to seek first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, then all these things can be added unto you. I tell you,